Now, we know eggs are in short supply, and that's because there's now a ban on caged hens.
With barn eggs and free range the only ones on offer, what about a forest free range farm? Here's Michael Holland.
The new day. And the charge is on. For the athletes, there's no looking back as the far-flung reaches beckon, while the homebodies are happy to hang close. Either way, the choice is theirs, even this straggler who stayed out overnight.
This is the naughty teenager. She didn't get to go inside last night, past her curfew.
The sprawling forest egg farm, 140 hectares all up.
We said, hey, we've got to do something different. Let's have a go at this forest concept. How do we make it work?
The new free-range face of an industry in transition.
This is natural for them. This is where they want to be. You've got stumps, you've got fallen down trees, you've got shrubs, you've got rock formations, you've got caves.
These certainly aren't the lone rangers, but they're the long rangers.
These are definitely the long rangers and the more adventurous, I think. When they leave that barn in the morning, they know exactly where they're going to their playground for the day.
And what are we, 300 or 400 metres away from the barn?
Yeah, we'd be 400 metres here.
You've populated this whole site with how many birds?
100,000 birds. Fair few, isn't it?
That's more than a one or two truckloads.
Yeah. When they arrive here on site, they're 15 weeks old, which we call a pullet chicken.
The forest farm, part of the Better Eggs group, which makes up almost a quarter of our retail egg market. That scale giving it the ability to develop this former forestry block at a time when smaller players have been struggling to reposition after the banning this year of cage birds and the country's two major supermarket chains deciding to stop selling colony eggs later this decade.
We looked around the world to see if there was any other concept similar to what we were trying to do. We couldn't find one that had been done at scale. And that's probably the key, at scale. So we believe what we've got at the forest is a world first. We're trying to look at it through the eyes of the future consumer, the future shopper. What's still going to be acceptable to the customer, to the consumer in 30, 40 years, and what do they expect free range to be? We've gone through that process, and animal welfare, the environment, sustainability, those are front of mind for customers and consumers, and they have to be for us as we build out these projects. We've planted over 90,000 trees.
90,000?
90,000. And more to come.
And the inscription on the rock up top suggests the forestry boys were here long before free-range egg farming.
Absolutely they were, and having a bit of fun along the way by the look, carving into rock formations.
When you first ventured onto this land, could you envisage this?
Venture is an interesting point. We had to see it from helicopter because it was all in trees. We were working off contour maps and instinct. We had a vision of what we wanted it to look like, birds roaming around on the floor of a forest, and this will become a forest as these trees continue to grow around us. We're just so proud. Anyone who wants to go and visit will make it happen. It's just so important that we are transparent around what we're doing.
And just maybe it's worth a visit for another, more indulgent reason.
I'm feeling mighty popular. At last, I've got a following.
Oh, they are living their best life. But is anyone else like me thinking, how do you round them up to get them back in?
I have no idea. How do they get them back in the shed? That's a good question.
A couple of farm dogs?
Yeah, do you think a couple of dogs would do the trick, or maybe some guinea pigs?
I don't
Well-trained
know.
Guinea pigs?
We need to find out from Michael.